Where the fuck did that come from? Sounds like shit. Up with the sun. To totally hear that distortion in there. She always said, I don't know if the mic's picking it up. Sounds like a compressed MP3 or something. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Alright. Friday before the holiday weekend. See how much trouble we can get in today. How many people we can piss off. Try to be good. Maybe some riders there, I don't know. They're looking at me and waving and shit. Either that or like the Gen 1 and a half. Maybe he heard me. That guy was about to turn into me, but he didn't see me. I think he fucking heard me. That's right, motherfuckers. Loud pipes save lives, bitches. So we could use this opportunity here to talk about motorcycle safety. So it's something I kind of been wanting to talk about a little bit, because I noticed the riding styles differ from rider to rider and say from state to state and whatnot. So I've always been an advocate of, there's like a couple goals when I ride, and one is to be seen. If people can see you, they're less likely to run into you. It's not like a for sure, like they're not going to run into you, but if people can see you, less likely to run into you. So how do you get people to see you? Well, you get your headlight in their mirror, okay? Now, riding in this position does a lot. I'm going to get over here and we'll talk about what I'm doing right now later. Your riding position can do a lot for you in terms of your visibility. But basically, if your headlight's in the mirror, then it's a lot easier, one of the side mirrors, not the rear view mirror, then it's easier for the driver of that car to see that you're there because you're shining your headlight in the mirror. Like in this instance right here, I'm much more visible to the car in front of me than I would be directly behind him right here. And the reason I want to talk about this is I just, my little shout out right now, it sounded like, reminded me of Psycho Cruiser. I love watching Psycho Cruiser. I love his energy. And I just like his attitude and stuff. But he did a motorcycle safety video not too long ago, and he talked about, lane positions and this and that. Now, he's an advocate of, on a two-lane highway, riding here. Okay, so this, in my opinion, is not where you want to be. On a two-lane highway, you want to be over here, okay? Now, some of you may say, oh, well, that puts you closer to the oncoming traffic, right? Yes, I'm closer to that car right now that passed by me. But the advantages of riding in this lane position versus the other one is, again, going back to visibility. More people can see me riding here. More people in the oncoming lane can see me, and more people pulling out of these driveways, especially on the right-hand side, okay? And we all know, all us motorcycle riders know that that's what gets us, is cars pulling out in front of us because they can't see us. Okay, so if you were to look at the angles from an aerial view of me being in this lane position versus this lane position and somebody being able to see me, same right here where this mailbox is, they're pulling out this driveway. It'd be a lot easier for them to see me if I was over here on this side. Making sense? Now, the only argument I would be able to say, okay, so if the shit's going south on the opposite side and you got people coming into your lane of travel, okay, you're gonna be closer to that oncoming traffic. Well, let me tell you this. If you're over here, now you just blocked your visibility for the oncoming traffic, okay? So now over here, I can't even see the oncoming traffic until they get right up on me. By being over here, I'm able to see much further down the road, okay? And being able to tell or not if there's something going bad up ahead, if there's a car spinning out of control up ahead and that's going to project something else coming into your lane, I can see, as far as I can see ahead, and I can be able to start making my reaction to the problem, a lot sooner than if I were riding over here and not being able to see what was going on. Okay, so look, I can't even see these cars' headlights until they get right in front of the Tesla. If I'm over here, I can see all the way down to the next curve. So, and look, my light's right in the closest mirror to the driver, so the driver knows I'm here, and I'm poking my headlight out over here, so the oncoming traffic is able to see me even that much more further. I feel, and I'm not a motorcycle instructor, I've just been riding quite a bit, and a lot of you guys know I was born and raised in Southern California, and they teach you a little bit different out there in California than riding here. In Oregon, there's even questions in the book, and it's ridiculous, about riding here in the center portion of the lane. You never ride here. You guys, I'm going to tell you right now, you should never be riding your motorcycle in the center portion of the lane like I am right now. And I see Oregon motorcyclists doing this on a daily basis. Okay, so let's talk about, you know, stop and go traffic on the freeway. Just seen it yesterday. You know, and you know, some of you guys know I split lanes or whatever, blah, 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 whatever. If I'm not splitting lanes and I'm in bumper to bumper traffic, you know, I'm right here, okay? And I'm trying to hug that dotted line as much as I can. And again, going back to the visibility part, it puts your headlight in the mirror and it's giving me a clearer path, a clearer view. So it's like, you know, if you're right behind, especially like a van or like a pickup truck maybe with a camper show in the back, if you're right behind them like this, what the fuck are you looking at besides the back of the car? You can't see any road hazards in front of you. You can't see shit. Even if you had to be over here, if you were in a group ride or whatever, staggered. See how much further I can see down the road from here versus being right behind the center of this car right here, but you can't see shit in front of you. So, if you guys always just, the easiest way to do this and to keep your bike in the right position is always just, you know, and it's funny too, because my manual in California, when I took the test, you know, 25 years or whatever ago, it specifically had questions on what lane positions are going to best keep your headlight in the mirror of the car, you know, and it all comes down to being visible, because, you know, when we get in these accidents involved with other cars pulling out in front of us, they're not, you know, or getting into us, you know, you guys getting all fucking pissed off because you got cars cutting you off and shit and pulling out in front of you. You guys, they can't see you. It's not their fault. And like I try to tell other riders when I talk to my buddies face to face, motherfuckers, they're not doing that shit on purpose, okay? They didn't wake up in the morning and go, oh, I'm gonna go cut off a couple motorcyclists today, okay? That's not the way the human brain works. Now, we got our crazies out there, and there's always the exception to the rule. But in general, you guys, if somebody cuts you off or pulls out in front of you and everybody's fine and there was no collision, you should be thanking that person for not fucking plowing into you, okay? And being happy that you didn't get smashed up by a car. That's the way I take it, okay? Now, there's, you know, and again, like I said, there's always exceptions to the rule, but, you know, for the most part, you guys, just remember, these cars can't see us. And most of the people driving these cars are nice people. Well, let's talk about the other problem with riding behind a car, just like this, okay? And this is a killer of motorcycle riders. I'm not even gonna stop here. Let's say, for instance, the Jeep behind me is, you know, gonna have a rear-end collision. This happens all the time. Cars bump each other, the person in front or the person behind is either on their phone, not paying attention, so they rear-end the car in front of them. What happens to me on a motorcycle if I'm in between those two cars? It's very simple, very cut and dry. I'm gonna get smashed in between two 4,000 to 6,000 pound metal object, and it's not gonna be very good, and motorcyclists die all the time from this, okay? Now, look at my lane position right now, okay? And think about the car behind me that's gonna rear end the car in front of me, okay? This position here is putting myself a little bit more in a safer spot, okay? And I'm being more visible to oncoming traffic, and I'm more visible to the car that just pulled out. I'm more visible to the car in front of me, okay? Now, I'm not saying I'm totally 100% in the clear if the car behind me wants to rear end this Tesla in front of me, but I'm at a better position. And I'll go one step further for this, you guys. If you guys come to a stop and you're at a stoplight or something, okay, and cars are piling up, what I do a lot of times is I point my motorcycle out. So like if I'm behind this Tesla, my bike will be pointing outwards like that. I don't know if you guys can see my hand very good. So on an angle. So if a car does come up and rear end me, he's gonna push me out away from the car in front of me, hopefully. Now, I'd rather much rather be pushed out into traffic or whatever than being smashed in between two cars, because you guys just Google it. It's nasty. You're literally getting smashed in between two cars, and it happens, and people die all the time from it. And that's one reason why I'm such a big advocate of lane splitting, lane sharing, lane filtering, whatever you guys want to call it. Because lane filtering eliminates the possibility of you being in a rear end collision, being sandwiched between two cars. Okay, because you're at a stoplight, you're gonna be at the front. It's gonna be impossible for another vehicle to rear end you because you'll be in between two cars. And on the freeway, when it's bumper to bumper traffic jam, you guys, you know, you see it all the time on the freeway. Fucking people rear-ending people. Okay, and if you're a motorcycle sitting in that bullshit right behind the car in front of you, you're gonna fucking get smashed up. So if you're out there hugging that dotted line and what have you, you know, I always tell my buddies, like, that's my alleyway. Like, you see this alleyway, that's my lane, okay? That's my escape route, you know? And so I'm always looking at those. If you're directly in behind a car, following a car in the middle of the lane, number one, you probably have target fixation on the back of that car. Number two, nobody can see you. Number three, you can't see what's on the road. I can just go on and on and on. No, you get in certain situations where you just, you can't do everything by the book all the time. And that's true with anything in life. So you got to be able to pick and choose, you know, what you're going to try to accomplish. And the best thing to do sometimes, like in this situation, is just hang back a little bit. You know, I don't have a good visibility of the road. I know, and you know, I got a lot of shit from people about tailgating sometimes, but you know, to me, it's not tailgating because, like I said, I'm in my alley, in my lane, in the center. And a lot of cagers that don't ride motorcycles, they can't comprehend that or see that, so they think you're tailgating them. Even a lot of motorcyclists do that don't lane split. They can't, you know, seem to comprehend what's really going on. If that car slammed its brakes on, I'm not stopping. I'm going straight past the car. So, but there's certain situations where you don't have that lane open to you or whatever, so you might just need to drop back, or you don't have the visibility, or you might be behind a bus or 18-wheeler, you know. But I don't know, guys. I hope that some of this information was useful. If you guys have any, like, you know, if there's anything that you guys have been thinking of or seeing out on the roads when you ride, put it down in the comments below, and you know, tell me what you think. You know, everybody has their own riding style, and everybody's different, and everybody has a different perception, right? But I guess that's it. Fuck it.